Hello there and welcome back, my fellow Pythonistas. In this video, we are going to, we are not going to talk about Python, but something pretty cool that I have recently discovered. What happens when you would like to, let's say, give your application a decent speed bump as to the I/O operations and what it can perform? So what I mean by this is that you have the possibility in Linux to create a space in memory or RAM that is able to serve you as a storage for files and I/O operations. And I'm going to introduce you to the RAM disk and the TMPFS concept. So how do we use it? What we need to do first is to create our folders. So mkdir, and we will create the RAM and the temp. Sorry. And for the mount, what we would like to say that we want to mount with the type of tempfs and tempfs to the mnt temp, and we would like to specify a size which should be, let's say, 1 gigabytes, so 1024 m, and we would also like to specify the RAM, and this RAM should be called RAMFS. RAMFS. Now, if we inspect with the df-h, we can see that we have the tempfs disk mounted, but we cannot see the RAM disk or RAMFS. And the reason for that is that RAM disk is an older solution, and it is not able to provide you with a dedicated space in memory. It is just going to say that on this path you are able to write directly to memory. And the problem with that is that you cannot, let's say, corner your application to a specific memory size. You can only say that this is the memory, you can use it. And the problem with this was that people experience application crashes, because when you are using the RAMFS, it is technically not protected from other applications to, let's say, take away a specific space from them in memory. When you have tempfs, when you exceed or try to exceed the limit that you have reserved, you will receive free space, and that can be handled by the application. So that is the, let's say, newer version. And let's take it for a test drive. So mount RAM, and we would like to provide the input file from the dev 0. And the output file should be called test.iso, and we should say that the BS is 1 megabytes, and the count is 512. And as you can see, it was a decent speed bump, so to speak. And let's inspect the free. I think this has a dash H. So it has a memory total swap used 500 megs. Let's do this once again with the test 2 and make it 1 gigs. So as you can see, it went with 1.7 gigabits per second, which is kind of a decent. So now what you can see that the amount of free memory has changed. So now what we need to do is to test out the mount and temp. And here we would also like to create one with the 512 megabytes. And as you can see, this was almost as fast as the other. And if we inspect with the free, how much is free, we are going to run out of free space, so to speak. So I'm going to create the test one with only 256 megabytes. And as you can see, as we are drawing closer to the limits of the memory that we have in our system, this is also getting slower and slower. But basically, this was all I wanted to show you. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thank you for watching.